Dear students, in this class I am going to talk about the another number system, that is octal number system followed by the hexadecimal number system. In the first unit we have been discussing the topic that is called number system. In the syllabus we have the four number systems, in which first one is very familiar to the human being, that is a decimal number system, in which we can have the 10 digits, 10 unique symbols, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. The base of that number system is 10, so that the total number of unique symbols or digits in that number systems are also 10. Whatever we use the number system in the daily lives, which are decimal numbers only, if we tell the if we quantify anything, that we will be quantifying by making use of the decimal numbers only. In the last class we have studied the decimal number system followed by the binary number system. Binary number system is the number system computer systems can deal with the numbers, that is called binary numbers only. So because computer can understand the language, that is binary language, and that we have studied in the previous class. The binary number system, in the binary number system we can have only two unique symbols which are called digits, such as 0 and 1. The base of that number system is 2. Base of that number system is 2 means the total number of digits in that particular number system are 2 only. In a binary number system we can represent any number, by making use of zeros and ones only. Then how to represent the decimal number in the binary number, in the last class we have studied. And again in reverse manner, if we have the binary number, then what will be its equivalent, the decimal number we have discussed. So with the last class we studied the decimal number system and as well as binary number system. In this class I am going to talk about the another number system whose name is octal number system. Octal means it is 8, which is having the base of 8. So in the previous classes I have given the introduction to the any number system. In any number system the starting digit will be 0 and the last digits in that number system will be the base minus 1. So that just now I told, the octal number system is having the base of 8. Octal means, octet means 8. Base is also called as radix. Base or radix, or radix of this number system is 8. We know that any number system will start with the digits, that is 0, and the last digits in that number system, last digit in that number system is base minus 1. Base is here 8, so that 8 minus 1 is 7. So that 0 to 7 digits we can have in this particular number system: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Total 8 digits are available, 8 unique symbols are available in this number system, so that the total number of unique symbols available in this number system is equivalent to its base only. The key point, first one, in any number system the starting digit is 0. Starting digit is 0. The starting digit or unique symbol we can call starting digit or unique symbol is zero only. That means what? This one. If you take the binary number system also, starting digit is zero only. If you take the decimal number system, the starting digit is zero only. Second point, the last digit or last unique symbol in that number system, last unique symbol in that number system is base minus 1. So if it is decimal number system, base is 10, 10 minus 1 will be the 9, so that it can have the digits from 0 to 9. If it is binary number system, base is 2 and the 2 minus 1 will be the 1, and so that it will have the digits 0 and 1 only. So now we are talking about the octal number system, so that octal number system is also starts with the digit that is 0. And the last digit in that number system is base minus 1, base is 8, 8 minus 1 will be the 7. If you go with the another number system, that is hexadecimal number system, whose base is 16, so that it starts with 0, and last digit in that number system will be the base minus 1, base is 16 minus 1 will be the 15, so that it will have the 0 to 15. The last key point in any number system, the total number of digits or unique symbols in any number system is equivalent to its base. For example, if you go with the octal number system, how many number of unique symbols are there? 8 digits are there. 8 is nothing but its base only. So that these are the 3 points can be valid for any number system in the world. And in the syllabus, we have the 4 number systems. We have the 4 number system in which the first one is the decimal number system. The human beings are very familiar with this number system. The next one is the binary number system. Computer can read the data in the binary form itself only. Next one is about the octal number system. Octal number system, some type of digital system can read the data in the form of octal. And the next one is a hexadecimal number system. Microprocessors and the microcontrollers will take the data in the form of hexadecimals. So that we have discussed that decimal in the last class, decimal number system in the last class, and the binary number system in the last class. Now I am going to cover the remaining 2 number system, which are octal number system and as well as hexadecimal number system. Then I am going with the octal number system, in which the starting digit is 0 and the last digit is about 7. And the total number of digits available in that number system is equals to its base. Base is here 8 only. So that we can write the number system based on the octal number system and the decimal number system. I am going with the one particular table now. Then I am going with the table. This is decimal number system. This is binary number system. Then what its equivalent? Octal number we have to study. Then decimal numbers are what? 0 to 9, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next one is what? 6, 7, 8, 9. After 9, next number in the decimal number system, it is a combination of the 2 digits 1 and 0, like 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Like that, we can have the any number in the decimal number system. Then what will be its equivalent binary numbers we have to study? What its equivalent octal numbers we have to study? See this one now. The point is here noted that in octal number system, we can have the digits from 0 to 7 only. We cannot see the 8, we cannot see the 9. so that without having the 8 and 9 we have to construct the number system, which is nothing but it is a octal number system. In binary number system, 0 will be 0, so that it is 0 and it is 0. In the decimal number, that is 1, and that remains same in the binary form 1, and that is remains same in the octal also. And the decimal is 2, because octal number is there from 0 to 7. So 2 in binary number we cannot have the 2, because it can have only 1 and 0. That 2 can be written as 10. In what way 2 can be written as 10, in the last class I have explained. And coming to the next one, 3, this 20 is nothing but that is octal 2. Octal decimal is 2, then octal is also 2. Then coming to here, this is 3 now. Then we can call it is 3. We can call it is 3. 3 means in the binary form it is 1. If the 3 is a decimal number, if we wanted to represent in the octal, that is same, 3 only. Then coming to the 4, 4 can be written as 100. And in the octal also 4 is there. Then 5, 101 in binary form. And in octal number system 5 is there. Then coming to here, 6 can be written in the binary form 110. In the octal form that is 6, because 6 is there. Coming to the 7 can be written as in the binary form 111, and the 7 is there. Coming to the 8 can be written in the binary form 1000. 1000, then that 8, we cannot have the 8 in the binary, we cannot have the 8 in the octal number system, so that 0 to 7 is completed, then next number will be the, after 0 to 7 completed, next one will be the 10. That means what? In the octal number system, we cannot have the 8 and we cannot have the 9. So that what? Directly, we went to the another number, that is 0 to 7 is completed, next one is 1 and 0 combination. Next one is 9. 9 can be written as 1001. That 9 will be written in case of octal number system, that is 11. How that can be written, I'll explain. Coming to the next one, 10 can be written 1010. That 10 will be 12 in case of octal number system. Then 111, that will be the 13. And next one is 1100, it is 12, and it will be the 14 in case of octal number system. Next one, 13 is nothing but it is 1101 in case of octal number, it is 15. Next one is 14110, it will be the 16, and 15 will be the all ones, and that will be the 17. If you go with the 16 will be 1 followed by the 4 zeros, 1 followed by the 4 zeros. After 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, if it is decimal number, we have to get 18, but there is no 8 in this number system. So that next will be the 20. Next will be the 20. You may have the doubt how this we have been getting. There is no doubt from 0 to 7. 0 to 7, there are the digits in the octal number only. But decimal 8 is converted into 10. That means what? We have the decimal 8 now. We have the decimal 8. We have to convert that is into the octal form. Very simple one. We have to convert that is into the octal form. Very simple manner. Then I am going to explain the same. See this one here, this is a decimal 8. Decimal 8 is converted into binary, and the decimal same 8 is converted into octal. Then how it will be? 8 take, then that is a decimal 1. We have to convert that is into octal, so that 8 is successively divided by 8. 1 and the remainder is 0. So that it is 10. If I am going with the 13 is a decimal number, I wanted to convert that is into the octal form. 13 I have taken, and it is divided successively by 8. 8 ones are 8 and remainder is 5, so that it is 15. So in that way, we can find the any number which is equivalent to the octal. And if you are having the octal, if you are having the decimal number, if you wanted to calculate its equivalent octal, simply we have to divide successively by the required base. Required base here, octal is nothing but it is 8. Then now take this one, 16. 16 is converted into binary, that is 1 followed by 40, and the same 16 is converted into octal, and that we got the 20. Then I will explain this one. See this one, 16 is there. Which number it is? It is a decimal number. We have to convert this decimal number into the binary number, base 2. We have to convert this decimal number into the octal number, which has the base is 8. Then take 16, we have to convert it into the binary, so that divide by 2 successively. 2, 8, that is 0, remainder 2, 4, remainder 0, 2, 2, remainder is 0, 2, 1, remainder is 0. So that what we got now? 1 followed by 4 zeros, 1 followed by the 4 zeros, it is the binary number. Then what its equivalent octal number? Take the 16, we have to convert that is into the octal, so that divide by 8. Successively divide by 8, so that 8 2 is 16, remainder is 0, so that answer is 20. So point is very very clear. If you have the number, if you have the decimal number, if you wanted to convert that is into the binary, so that you have to divide that by the successively with its base of 2. If you wanted to convert the decimal, given decimal number into the octal, you have to divide that given decimal number successively with the required base of 8. This is only the simple thing. Then I am going with the one general example now. For example, I am having the number of 117 base 2. Which equivalent, 117 base 10 it is. Base 10 means it is a decimal number. 107 is a decimal number. If I convert that is into the binary, then what will be its equivalent? If I convert the same into the octal, then what will be its equivalent? We must know. Then I am going with the successive division. Here it is a decimal number, we have to convert into the binary. So that take 117 and successively divide by 2. 2 5s are 10, remainder is 1, that is 17. 2 8s are 16, remainder is 1. 2 this is 29, remainder is 0. 2 14, remainder is 1. 2 7, remainder is 0. 2 3, remainder is 1. 2 1, remainder is 1. So that what? From the bottom to top, we have to collect all the remainders. That is what? 111 01 01. This equivalent is equals to what? 111 01 01 base 2. That means what? 11. If 117 is a decimal number, is converted into binary, that will be in binary is 111 01 01 base 2. If you wanted to convert that is into the octal, that 117 is a decimal number, we wanted to convert that is into the octal, so that 8 1s are 8, so that remainder is 3, 3 7 37, 5 is 40, then 8 4s are 32, remainder is 5, and again 8 1s are 8 and remainder is 6, so that we can collect this is 165. It is an octal number which is having the base of 8. That means what? 117 base 10 is a decimal number. If we convert that is into the octal number, that will be, that is 165 base 8. Then we can verify. Then I am concluding this process. If we are having a decimal number, decimal number whose base is 10, we know that it is a decimal number whose having the base of 10, and if it wanted to convert into any number system, what is the procedure? simply we have to take the base of the required number system which we have to be which we have to get, and that with that base of that particular number system we have to divide that given decimal number successively, and we have to collect the all the remainders from the bottom to top. This is only the procedure. Decimal to any number system, decimal to any number system. For example, decimal is what? It is having the base of 10. It is having the base of 10, and we wanted to convert that into base of x. That means what? We have to take this number, and with this base successively we have to divide this one, and so that we have to collect all the remainders from the bottom to top, and that will be the equivalent number to that particular decimal number in the required number system. This is the generalized procedure for all the decimal to any number system. Now I am going. So by taking one example, I am going to conclude this one. First one, I am taking the example, that is I am having the decimal number, that is 55. Assume that 55 base 10, we have to convert this is into what will be its equivalent of binary number, then what will be its equivalent of octal number whose base is 8. Simply we have the decimal number, we have to convert into base 2, we have to convert into base 8. Very simple. I am taking the 55, and what is the required base? Required base is 2, so that divide by 2 successively and collect the remainders. 2 2's are 4, remainder is 1, 15, 2 7 is 14 and remainder is 1. Then 2 13, 26, remainder is 1. 2 6, 12, that is remainder is 1. 2 3, remainder is 0. 2 1, remainder is 1. That means what? From the bottom to top we have to collect all the remainders. Now what are the remainders we have from the bottom to top? 1 double 1 0 triple 1. Then this equivalent is what? We have double 1 0 triple 1, which is completely a binary number. And coming to the second question, what is the second question? Here we have the same 55 which is there in the decimal number system. We have to convert that is into the octal, so that 55 is successively divided by 8. 8 7s are 56, 8 6 48. So that here if 8 into 6 48 and the remainder is 7. Simply we got these only. See this one. So that answer for this one is what? If the 55 is there in the decimal number system, if we convert that is into the octal form, we got the 67 base 8. One may have the doubt whether these are right or wrong. Then you can verify in the reverse manner. Take that binary number now. Then I am taking the binary number. What are the binary number we have? The 1, 1, 0, double 1 and 1. It is a binary number. Then what its equivalent decimal we wanted to calculate? So that 1 into 2 power of 0, 1 into 2 power of 1, 1 into 2 power of 2, 0 into 2 power of 3, 1 into 2 power of 4, 1 into 2 power of 5. Then add all of them, then you will get the clarity. This is what? 1 into 2 power of 5, 32. 1 into 2 power of 4, it is 16. 0 into anything, 0 only, plus 1 into 2 power of 4 is 24. The 1 into 2 power of 1 is 2. This 1 into 2 power of 0 will be 1. This will be what? It is 48, 52, 54, and this will be is equals to 55 base 10. Then coming to the second one, so that see this one, if it is a binary number system, 110111 is a binary number, then its equivalent will be the 55 only, just now we verified. Then same case I am having, same case I wanted to verify this 67, we are saying that it is a 67 is a octal number and which is equivalent to 55 of base 10, whose base is 10, so that you simply go with the 67, 6 and it is 7, write this, and so that go with the same here, it is the binary number system, so that we have used the positional weight is 2, so that here it is octal number, we have to make use the 8, that is 8 power of 0 plus 6 into 8 power of 1. So 6 into 8 power of 1, 8 into 6, this is 8 into 6, it will be 48. 48 plus 7 into 8 power of 0 will be 1 only, that is 7, so that 48 plus 7, it will be the 55 base 10. Like this, we can convert any number, we can convert the decimal number to any number, from any number to any number to a decimal number. For example, it is very very important, we have one number system, that means what, we have the number that is 125 base is x, we don't know what is the value of x, then its equivalent, what its equivalent decimal number we should calculate, what its equivalent decimal number we have to calculate. In such cases what we have to do, same thing, we have to do what, 1 2 3, it is in one number system, we don't know that number system, so that we have to convert that is into the octal, that is a decimal number system, simply 5 into x power of 0 plus 2 into x power of 1 plus 1 into x power of 2, so that it is what, x square plus 2x plus 5 is equals to, if here it is having any number, if it is having any number, for example it is having some 14, it is having, assume that, so that by finding the x value, by making use of the simplification, if you find the x value, then you can get the required base. The simple point here is that if you are having the decimal number and if you wanted to convert that is into any number system, so that we have to divide the decimal number successively by the required base, so that we have to collect the all the remainders from the bottom to top, that will be the equivalent of that particular decimal number to any number system. That is one procedure. Coming to the next reverse manner, if you are having one number, if you are having a number in one particular number system, if you wanted to convert that is into the decimal, simply we have to multiply each and every digit of that number with its positional weights. These are the positional weight, 2 power of 0, 2 power of 1, 2 power of 2, that is nothing but positional weights. So that if you multiply and add with the positional weights, then you will get the decimal number. This is about the decimal number to any number system and any number to decimal number system. Decimal to any number and any number to decimal. And in the next class, I am going to explain about the another number system, that is called another number system, that is called hexadecimal number system. Hexadecimal number system is a number system which has the base of 16, so that in that particular number system, starting a digit or a starting unique symbol is 0, and the last digit in that number system is about the 16 minus 1, that is base minus 1, it is 15, and it can have the total number of unique symbols in that number system is equivalent to its base only. In the next class, I am going to explain the hexadecimal number system, and I am also going to review the all the number system that are decimal number system, octal number system, binary number system and hexadecimal number system. With that, all the number system, almost 80% of the first unit will be closed. And next topics in the first units are some complements we have to study, some logic families, just a list of the logic families we have to describe. With that, first unit will be successfully completed. Thank you, students.